Good morning, students. Welcome again to another lesson. Today we're tackling something in poetry to do with persona. Welcome. So if you look at the board, we have the title, Poetry, Identifying the Persona. So when it comes to studying poetry, it's very important that you understand persona because it's going to help you to understand the entire poem. So according to the definition, a persona is the voice of the speaker in a poem. So whenever you're reading a poem, you always hear a voice speaking. There's always a speaker speaking that poem. So even in real life, sometimes when you look at musicians, or you look at presenters, or you look at people, for example, your friends in drama festival, or your friends in music, sometimes when they're presenting an item, they take on a new character. That new character is what you're calling persona. For example, in a school, you may have an all-boys school, and maybe in your drama presentation, the part where a lady speaks. So you find a boy wearing a dress and then begins to speak in the voice of a female. In that case, the boy has taken on the persona of a female. So it's not who he is in real life, but he's trying to speak to the audience in a voice to make them understand what he's talking about. So that taking on a new voice or a new character is what is referred to as persona. So most of the time, the person speaking in the poem may not be exactly the same person speaking, the same sex or gender of the person who wrote the poem, or the same age group or whatever, because the poet is taking on a new character in order to address something to the audience, to make it more believable. So if you look at the second point, you say persona is applied in poetry to refer to the character through whom the poet addresses the audience. The poet will use a voice or an assumed role of a character, which represents his or her thoughts. That is, the specific person the poet wants to present as his mouthpiece. So sometimes the speaker or the poet or the person who wrote that item does not want to speak directly from his own voice, but he wants to use another voice to make his message more effective. Therefore, persona is also referred to as the speaker. So most of the time, the persona can take the first person perspective, whereby you find in the poem they use the first person, I. Or sometimes it could be a third person, a singular, whereby they use him, her, or she, whereby the persona is now observing another person. So in the poem, we could have the experience of the persona in the first person perspective, or as an observer looking at another person who's experiencing things in the poem. So when it comes to identifying persona, just look at the choice of the words in the poem to help you understand who may be speaking. For example, if the poem talks about my wife has gone to the market, then you know the persona is a husband. The fact that he has a wife who has gone to the market will make us know that this is a husband speaking, okay? If the poem talks about breastfeeding, I breastfed you, I raised you up, then you know it's a mother, because a mother normally breastfeeds the child. So there are going to be a few choice words from the poem to help you know who the persona is. So the persona could be a husband, could be a mother, could be a parent, could be a father, could be a wife, could be a teacher, could be a girl or a boy, could be a man or woman, could be a soldier, could be a doctor, could be a freedom fighter, could be a child, could be a politician, could be a grandchild, could be a patriot, a lover, a mourner, an initiate, for example, if the poem is talking about circumcision, or simply an observer. In this case, the observer is not going through whatever he's discussing in the poem, but is observing another person go through things in the poem. So it's very important when it comes to the study of poetry, the first thing you need to understand is the persona, who is speaking the poem, which voice or which character has the poet chosen to speak to you as the audience. So just by looking for a few choice words in the poem, you get a clue on what the persona is. And remember, don't force the gender on the persona. If the poet is quiet on it, or if it's not specific, then maintain a neutral or a gender neutral term. You can use he or she, or you can use they. For example, if the poem is talking about a child, or a parent talking to a child, and they've not given some indicators that it's either mother or a father, you simply go with a parent, or you can go with mother or father, because you don't know the sex of that person. If an observer, you know the person, just use the word someone. So never ever specify unless the poem is explicitly showing that the person is either male or female. So we look at a sample of a poem that I have on the board by Joseph Kariuki and see if you can be able to derive the persona in this case. So the poem goes, when you left without a word, my heart wept not so much for lost love and touch but more for the blinkers which I wore for so long, which I wore. For so long, for so late, did I worship such an ingrate. So if you look at this poem, it's a very good example of how to find the persona. In this case, you can look at the choice of words. For example, the persona talks about when you left without a word. He talks about the heart weeping because of the word lost, love. Already you can see where this poem is going. It's more likely a love poem whereby someone is mourning about their lost love. So in this case, definitely, the persona must be a jilted lover because he was in love with somebody and this person has abandoned them. And now he's talking about what he feels after the person has left them. So in this case, they're going to give us the answer, who the persona is. You can go and look at those choice words. I've given you two examples on how you can do it. For example, you can be asked, who is the persona in this poem? You say, a jilted lover, that's the persona. And then you go on to give us the evidence, how you arrived at that. So the lover has been left by the object of his or her affection. In this case, when you left, then you leave some ellipsis dots, then my heart went. So here I'm giving evidence how I arrived at jilted lover. The second we have, or you can choose to just use maybe one noun to identify that person, or you can simply go to explaining who you think the other person is. So the two ways which you can do it. So it depends on what you're comfortable doing. Either way, it still makes sense. So you can identify and then explain, or you can just go simply to explaining and then choose some words from the poem to explain how you arrived at your answer. In this case, the second one is, the persona is a lover who has been jilted or abandoned by their partner when you left. So there you can be able to see how to easily identify the persona. So the few choice words from the poem will indicate to you what the persona is. So as you can see from that example, it's very easy to know who a persona is. So from now onwards, I'll encourage you, just learn how to know the persona. Even the music you listen to, your favorite musicians, not all of them sing as themselves. They take on a persona. You may find a musician singing about lost love, but you look at their real life, they are married maybe with children. So whatever you're singing about, they've put themselves in the shoes of that person or that character and try to use that character to present to you the poem. But they're not speaking from their own personal experience, probably. But they're just trying to empathize and sympathize with their listeners who've gone through the same and maybe try to encourage them to the song. So the persona is normally the voice or the character to which a poet decides to communicate to the audience. Then we have another example here. It's a long poem, but I've just taken a small part of it. It's called Argument with God. And it goes, my child was struggling for life in hospital, and I, worried, tense and tired, sat in silent prayer, in violent silence, arguing with my God. God, I say, why do you allow him to suffer so? Why him all the time? Why? God was silent, not a word from him, not a word. So from the choice of words we've seen from this poem, automatically you can know who's speaking. In this case, when they say, my child was struggling for life in hospital, then automatically you know it's a parent who is talking in that case. So when you're answering, you can go straight to just paraphrasing what I've just said, or simply just identifying using a noun and then explaining. So you have two options. The first one I've written, the persona is a parent with a sick child in hospital. So that's also scores. Or you can simply write a parent and then explain, my child was struggling for life in hospital. So both ways we still score. Or simply you can say the persona is either a mother or a father, because from the way the poem has been written, it does not specify the sex of the parent. And that's why when it comes to persona, don't always assume the sex or the gender of the person. Just look at the poem and see who is speaking. Unless the examiner has specifically specified for you, or the poet has shown from the choice of words that the person is speaking is either female or male. So you can identify using a noun, a parent, and then give evidence. My child struggling for life in hospital. Or you can just go simply to explaining. The persona is a parent with a child in hospital. So both things are just the same. It's like the synonyms of each other. So you have the freedom to choose how you want to answer the question. So the last part, I'll give you an example of another poem. It's a very short one. And try to see if you can get who is the persona in the poem. It's a very simple one. So the poem goes, I thank thee, mother. I thank thee, mother. Your back I wet when I licked like a broken gun. Your breast I sought like a blind bat. On your back I swung like a vagabond. But you said, it's my vagabond. So you will try to decipher and read it on your own time and see if you can find the persona in the poem. So with those few remarks, I wish you all the best and have a good day until the next lesson. Thank you.